I play a character called Curly Dean. He's a traditional trawlerman, and you know, it's kind of in his skin, in his bones to be a trawlerman. His dad was a trawlerman, his granddad, his great granddad. So he's very, very passionate about, you know, about what he does. And you know, kind of the moment I read the script, really, I fell in love with it straight away. And the minute I got cast, it was very, very important to me to, you know, to go and meet these guys, meet these ex-trawlermen, and find out about their stories, about, you know, life out at sea, life on land as well. And, you know, really get into the character and feel a part of that, so.
These people love where they live, they love their life. Can you talk a little bit about the importance of celebrating a part of this country that has been so often maligned on screen?
Absolutely, very important question there, really. You know, the people of Grimsby are very, very passionate about where they're from and their heritage and, you know, their history. And I think it's so, so important that we've, you know, that we've made this film, and we really hope that we've done the people of Grimsby justice, really, in portraying a really nice story, you know, realistic about what's actually happened, but also, you know, how good the people are and how friendly they are. And it was great to meet them and work with them as well. You know, a lot of the people of Grimsby were extras in the film, and I think it was really special to have them a part of the film. I think it meant a lot, really.
In terms of our core gang, can you talk a little bit about the unique balance between these four very different characters?
Yeah, you know, you've hit the nail on the head there, really. You know, we all are very, very different. And again, we tried to spend 2 weeks before we filmed the film just bonding, you know, really, and going out on the beach and walking and talking and going to the amusements in Grimsby and just lapping it all up, really. And they're all so very different, but they all play such a massive role in the film. They're individual, like, personalities. It just combines the film together and makes it really, really special. But as, you know, as real people and as cast and stuff like that, it was really important to spend that time together, and hopefully that really shows out in the film. So, yeah, we'll see. We've already kind of been compared to that there's a certain style of Guy Ritchie in there. And do you know what? I really like that, because, like, Guy Ritchie is a favourite director of mine. And that's kind of what drew me to the script straight away, was the fact that the character was, you know, directly speaking to the camera as I am now, and sort of narrating the film as well. And I really like that style personally. But it's definitely got its own uniqueness. You know, the fact that it's in Grimsby, the fact that it's so real, it's kind of got a little bit of Shane Meadows in there with the improvisation and the freedom that we had with Jack was incredible. And I thank Jack for that. And that's where the magic is tonight. So that's down to Jack.
You mentioned Jack there. Can you talk a little bit about what makes him such a very special storyteller?
Jack's a young guy, and at the end of the day, he's got love and he's got passion, and you can see that from day one. The moment that we spoke on Skype, you know, I kind of knew straight away that his drive and his passion was incredible. As a storyteller, he's very, very detailed about what he does, but he's also quite freelance. So, you know, he's very free with the actors, and that's what the actor loves, you know, to have that freedom. And I think it's very important. It's like a mutual decision between the actor and the director, and I think getting that right is just perfect, and that's exactly what Jack did on this. So, yeah, well done, Jack. Well done, mate.
I'm curious if there's a particular memory you have from set that makes you smile the most, or is kind of symbolic of the kind of bond that you had making this.
I mean, with the rest of the cast, like, you know, all the scenes were just incredible. We had such a laugh filming it. We really did. I mean, it was very difficult. I'm not going to say it was all glory, you know, because it's difficult when you're filming a low budget film. But the way they've made it look, it looks incredible. It looks like a high budget film. But hello, mate. But, you know, like, at the same time, for me, I think the scene between me and my dad in the film was very special. It was very emotional, and it was a really special moment. That he's an incredible actor, and hopefully you'll see that tonight, and you might even shed a tear.
This film is being held out as an astonishing example of the true power of independent cinema. Can you talk about what you think both a storyteller and an audience gets from indie cinema that perhaps don't from other types of film?
I think just the realness of it and the grittiness, you know, with the big box office Hollywood films nowadays, it's all, you know, it's either Marvel or it's, you know, it's all crazy. It's a little bit far-fetched kind of thing. And I think with a film like this, it's very real. It's about the Grimsby people. It's about working class people. And that's the main key to it. And I think we show the love and the passion that comes from Grimsby. And for me, that's the most important thing about this film.